In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the union of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Connie died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Another reminder of this baptism. In baptism, Connie received the sign of the cross. May she now share in Christ's victory over sin and death.
Thank you. my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day. The Gospel of the Lord.
Please be seated.
Or things just coming together. No, there's purpose because God who is love, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, eternal communion of love, desire to create all of the universe, all of humanity in this love. But love requiring freedom, a love that could be rejected. That's what we saw in our first parents, Adam and Eve. They're created in this, but then through the temptation of Satan easily turning away. A brokenness that's continued human history ever since. A brokenness very evident in our world today. Maybe very evident within our own lives. But in this brokenness that God does not give up on us. But God throughout history, this is what we read through the Old Testament, God reaching out in many different ways through his prophets, through his saints, holy men and women. And ultimately coming to Jesus of Nazareth. A historical person who truly lived, but then who claimed to be the Son of God. Who would back up that claim through the miracles and signs that he wrote, that he gave. Through the friendships that he established with his disciples, with many men and women. Reaching out in healing, reaching out in grace. But ultimately, because love is freedom, ultimately being rejected, being nailed to the cross, the suffering, which especially in this time of Lent, as Christians we remember. But even Jesus receiving that to show us that love for us, to show us on the cross that every sin, every element of that brokenness, he took into himself. And he said in the midst of that, Father, forgive them, they know not what they do. And as he died, all of that sin, all of that brokenness was put to death. Because as St. Paul says in our second reading, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Now we place ourselves here. Jesus is there on the cross so that we don't have to be there. And so that in rising from the dead, as the Son of God, Jesus conquers death, shows us the glory of his body, still has his body at the right hand of the Father, and desires to share that with us today. St. Paul says, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life, be united with him in the resurrection. That's the promise we cling to today, that we pray for each other as we pray for Connie, that in her life, throughout her life, she experiences, but that even now we pray that the Lord may receive her into that same life, into that same love. May forgive her of any sins, but be trusted fully to his love. And in the midst of that, we receive God's love for ourselves. And he reaches out to us even now in our grief, that we remain with him. And in this Eucharist, he gives us this reminder that we as Catholics believe that words of the priest, just as the Last Supper, Jesus said, this is my body, this is my blood, given for you. Made fully, actually present with us, both here and in communion. And that God desires to unite us with each other through this love that we can share, this love that we can experience even now, this love that Connie experienced throughout her life and then was able to share with so many of you in so many different ways. When I was in the back of the narthex, just spending a little bit of time in prayer before the urn, I was noticing, especially on this beautiful sunny day that we have, a great contrast to what we've been having recently. But through the stained glass window that we have in the back, St. Patrick there, but then the people surrounding St. Patrick receiving this news, and maybe some of you noticed as well, but there was a reflection upon the urn of, there was a young girl in the image back there, just filled with joy. This image that was reflected on the urn. Just seeing that, that's an image of the joy God wants to give each one of us, that he gave Connie, that we pray he's continuing to give in so many awesome ways, but that he wants to continue to share with us. Certainly, grief is a process, something that will happen throughout these next weeks, throughout these next months or years. The adjustment will take place. But that you can provide that comfort for each other. Remain with each other in that same love, in that same mercy. So I encourage you today to spend that time. Share stories about Connie's life. How she impacted you, those virtues that she lived out. And be united in prayer, both here at this Mass and then throughout these days and weeks to come. As we pray for Connie, to know that the parishioners here at St. Patrick will continue to pray for her. to be able to hear what Jesus then says in this gospel in a new way. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me. So as we pray that Jesus receives us, just as he may receive Connie and me to the same love. It's that united in him, we too may experience this life that we hear about. So Father, we entrust everything to you, to your will, which even in our brokenness and our sin and in our sorrow, you desire to work all things for your love, for your good, that you redeem everything through the cross of your Son and the power of your Holy Spirit. Fill us with the same life as we entrust Connie to you. Allow us to know your forgiveness, to know your peace, and to one day, through faith, through this love of you, through this church, receive this eternal life.
Please stand as we offer petitions and prayers for our Heavenly Father. Praying for Connie, also praying for her husband Lee, praying for all of us in this time, knowing that God desires to console us in the same love through his promises. That confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
For Connie, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Connie, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of Connie, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord. For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the rewards of goodness, we pray to the Lord. For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord. For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated as the altar's prepared.
Oh,
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Connie, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, giving you thanks, and said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself.
Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, through blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servants Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Connie, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you in their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him,
O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Please stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await with blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let's
acknowledge those around you with a suitable sign of peace. Pray the Father's peace to enter their hearts. Because of our nature of belief in the Eucharist, if you're Catholic and prepared to receive,
life of faith, to receive communion, you can come forward. If you're not a Catholic, you're still very welcome to come forward to receive a blessing. Simply indicate that by placing your hands across your chest like so. Pray that Christ may enter your heart. Pray for Christian unity.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Moment of silent prayer, just simply ask our
sorrow to entrust everything to him. He entrusted Connie to him. Jesus, he's promised to remain with us. You promised to take us to yourself. Allow us to experience that now in a new way. Saints and angels present, especially Mary, the mother of Jesus, as Jesus gave her to us as our mother as well. We ask her intercession to pray, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Connie, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Connie again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Connie,
and assure in certain hope that, together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Connie in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servants and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.